In early November, at its 2021 Community Summit, Facebook gave us a sneak peek of some of the new tools that they plan on launching within Facebook groups. And y'all, they have some pretty exciting stuff lined up for us. So if you are a current Facebook group administrator, or if you've been thinking about starting your own Facebook group, then stay tuned, because in this video, I'm going to cover three of the new tools and features that Facebook plans on launching within Facebook groups here shortly. Hi y'all, I'm Vivian Walton, the Seasoned Marketer, and I share marketing tips, tools, and tactics with resourceful business owners. Facebook groups have been a really great resource for small business owners who are looking to grow a community online. Creating and maintaining a Facebook group often provides opportunity to nurture existing relationships that you may have with current customers, and also to create new relationships with potential future customers, people that will down the road buy your products and services. Or it's also a great way to just build a community around a particular topic, interest, or niche. If you are currently using Facebook groups to create awareness for your business or brand, let me know in the comments below. Has creating a Facebook group helped you grow your business? As with all things Facebook right now, Meta is working on improving the experience within every single feature of the Facebook platform, including Facebook groups. So within the next year, you can expect to see a facelift when it comes to the Facebook groups feature. So without further ado, let's jump right in and start talking about three of the most intriguing tools that they plan to launch within Facebook groups. Number one, subgroups. Facebook is testing a subgroup option, which would allow Facebook group administrators to go in and divvy up their Facebook group into even more targeted and niche down communities. For example, let's say that I own a clothing boutique and I've created a group where I share not only the latest trends in clothing, but also my sales every Friday. So what I could do then is take my Facebook group and actually divvy it down into subgroups such as summer trends, fall trends, and Friday sales. Now, where things get really exciting is that Facebook has told us that there's going to be a paid element option to this, meaning that if I wanted to take that Friday sales subgroup and charge a one-time $4.99 fee in order for somebody to join, because that's where I'm offering the lowest discount, so maybe I give them an additional 5% off or 10% off for anyone that joins that particular group, then that is allowing me to create some type of a membership where these subgroup participants are receiving an added benefit. And that really opens up a whole lot of options for small business owners. Number two, capability for non-Facebook users to join your group. According to Facebook, they want to make Facebook groups more accessible to those in the broader community. In order to accomplish that, Facebook is testing an option that would allow Facebook group administrators to allow people without Facebook accounts into their group. Facebook didn't give much details about how exactly that would work or what it would even look like, but that does mean that if you currently have a Facebook group or you plan on creating a Facebook group, you could grow that group even larger because you're able to access people without Facebook accounts, which means that you could drive up engagement and your community can grow. Number three, community awards. Facebook has been testing this option for some time now, but it seems like they're finally going to be releasing it to all Facebook groups. But it is the ability for Facebook group administrators to dish out awards to participants within the group. The idea behind community awards is really to encourage good community engagement and also to encourage the top contributors within each one of these groups to continue to post and to engage within the group. Now, these are only three of the most intriguing tools that Facebook told us they were going to be adding to Facebook groups. Among others were the opportunity to create stylized or customized fonts and colors within Facebook group, so that way it could match your business or brand, and also being able to send an increased amount of welcome messages to people that are just now joining the group. So those are all exciting opportunities, and I can certainly create a video on those later on down the road, but it does look like Facebook is serious about putting forth the time and effort research and development to help us create communities where people can come in, connect, and also giving our businesses an opportunity to get in front of people more often. If you like this video, remember that every Monday I release a video just like this that could help you save time and money when it comes to marketing your business. Don't forget that I also have a website at www.theseasonmarketer.com where I have a couple freebies there for you to download today. So go check that out. Thanks again for tuning in. I'll catch you guys next week, same time and place.